Recommendations. My name is Sarah, and today I am jumping in with the monthly recommendations group that was started by Trina from Between Chapters and Kayla Rain. I will link all of the info for both of their channels and the Goodreads group in the description below if you would like to join us. For the month of June, we are sharing our favorite retellings. Now, to be perfectly honest, retellings are a pretty new thing for me. It's not because I ever intentionally avoided reading them, I just never really thought to seek them out. So, with the exception of a couple that I read in the middle school, high school timeframe, most of the retellings that I've read have been within the last couple of years since I joined BookTube. I think almost all of them that I'm going to share with you fall under that category. All that said, today I'm going to share with you sort of three different groupings of retellings. There's a couple of standalone retellings that I happen to really love, a series that is all retellings, and then multiple retellings of one of my favorite stories. So let us begin. Up first, we have Redeeming Love by Francine Rivers. This is a Christian historical fiction retelling of the Book of Hosea that takes place during the California Gold Rush in the 1850s. I read it for the first time in 2007, right after my senior year in high school, and absolutely fell in love with it. I don't read a lot of Christian fiction, to be perfectly honest, because I have rarely been impressed with the quality of it, but Francine Rivers is one of the few, almost the only Christian fiction author that I read on a regular basis. This was one of the first books that I read by her, and I haven't read the book in years, so it's possible my perspective on some things will have changed, but if you are looking for a retelling of this particular story, and if you are just looking for a good Christian fiction author, a lot of her stuff is really fantastic. Up next we have Till We Have Faces by C.S. Lewis. Till We Have Faces is one of my all-time favorite books. I read it for the first time during my junior year in high school and absolutely fell in love with it. I reread it almost every single year, and every time I pick it up, it is just as wonderful as the first time. It is a retelling of the myth of Cupid and Psyche, told from the perspective of Psyche's older sister, sort of in a ugly stepsister's version of the fairy tale kind of situation. It's C.S. Lewis's favorite book that he ever wrote, and I think for very good reason, because it is a weird and kind of bizarre story at points, and you might spend a lot of it wondering what the point of the whole story is, but then you get to the end, and it's just so fantastic and amazing, and I love everything about it. I recommend it to pretty much everybody ever. So those are my standalone retelling recommendations. Now, my series retelling recommendation is one you might be able to guess, and that is The Lunar Chronicles by Marissa Meyer, which includes Cinder, a retelling of Cinderella, Scarlet, a retelling of Red Riding Hood, Cress, a retelling of Rapunzel, and Winter, a retelling of Snow White. I binge read pretty much this entire series in the fall of 2015, right around the time that Winter came out, and it is such a fun series. Like I said, each individual story is a retelling of a fairy tale, Cinderella, Red Riding Hood, Rapunzel, or Snow White, and the villain that runs through the entire series is the Evil Queen from Snow White, but each story builds on itself with the characters from Cinder showing up in Scarlet, the characters from Scarlet showing up in Cress, the characters from Cress showing up in Winter, and it's just a really, really fun, fantastic series that takes these very traditional, well-known, and loved fairy tales and flips them on their head in this post-World War III sci-fi kind of realm where Cinderella is a cyborg and Rapunzel is a hacker, and there's just a lot of really fun, fantastic things about it. But at the same time, Marissa Meyer is really intentional about putting those little bits and pieces of the original stories into the retellings that she has created. So if you're looking for a series of really fun, engrossing retellings that have fantastic friendships and multiple swoonworthy romances, I would definitely recommend checking out The Lunar Chronicles. I did individual reviews on all four of the main books, which I will link in the description below if you would like to hear my more extensive thoughts. And the final set of retellings that I have to share with you are all retellings of one of my all-time favorite stories. You might be able to guess, it is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. The first Pride and Prejudice retelling I have to recommend to you is Eligible by Curtis Sittenfeld. Eligible is part of the Jane Austen Project, which is where various authors do a modern adaptation of the different Jane Austen stories. Eligible is the only one that I have read from the Jane Austen Project, and while I did not love absolutely everything about it, I recommend it because it is a very unique and fresh feeling adaptation of the Pride and Prejudice story. Generally, when you're dealing with a Pride and Prejudice adaptation, whether it be in book, movie, or TV form, your characters tend to be in their teens or 20s, and in this particular adaptation, Lizzie is in her late 30s, Jane is almost 40. There are just a lot of really unique things about the way that Lizzie and Darcy's relationship develops, about the way that Jane and Bingley's relationship develops, and about a lot of the other major things that happen throughout the story. Very unique and quite unpredictable. The only sticking point that I have with this particular adaptation is that there is a lot of diversity represented, which I really, really loved because I am very much an advocate for diverse representation in literature. However, at points it felt like certain characters or situations were thrown into the story just to check that kind of diversity off of a list. Many of the situations and characters that provided diverse representation were done very well and fit very well in the story and are part of what contributed to making it such a unique retelling and adaptation, but there were a couple of different characters and situations that were thrown in there closer to the end of the story that almost felt like it was going, oh, I have this and this and this and this kind of diversity, and so this kind of diversity needs to get checked off as well, which irked me a little bit, but it was still a really fun and unique adaptation. So if you are looking for something that is very much not your typical Pride and Prejudice adaptation, definitely check this one out. Up next, we have First and Then by Emma Mills. So this one is not a strictly Pride and Prejudice adaptation. It is all feel-good, cheesy, adorable wonderfulness. I read it pretty much in one sitting. It follows Devin Tennyson, who is a high school senior, and it sort of takes most of the elements of the Pride and Prejudice story while also throwing in various plot points and elements from some of the other Jane Austen stories like Mansfield Park and the like. So it still gives you that familiar, like, hate to love Darcy Lizzie kind of situation, and a lot of the things that happen in the Pride and Prejudice story are adapted well for this particular story, but it also feels very fresh and new and unique because of the fact that there are other elements of Jane Austen stories thrown into this particular adaptation as well. And finally, perhaps my all-time favorite adaptation retelling of Pride and Prejudice that I have encountered, The Secret Diary of Lizzie Bennet by Bernie Sue and Kate Rorick. Now, if you are familiar with The Secret Diary of Lizzie Bennet, then you know that this is a companion novel to The Lizzie Bennet Diaries, the YouTube series that was created by Hank Green and Bernie Sue, Pemberley Digital. It is delightful and amazing and wonderful. And to be perfectly honest, if you have not watched The Lizzie Bennet Diaries, then The Secret Diary of Lizzie Bennet is not going to make a whole lot of sense. So this is more or less my plug to say that my all-time favorite adaptation of Pride and Prejudice, book, movie, TV, whatever, is this particular adaptation. They're actually redoing it right now because it is the 5-year anniversary of the Lizzie Bennet Diaries, and so if you like the Lizzie Bennet Diaries on Facebook, they are reposting all of the different elements of the story, the YouTube videos, the Twitter conversations, and the like, almost in real time on the Facebook page, and it is so fun because I discovered the Lizzie Bennet Diaries after it was already done. I binge watched literally the entire thing in one day, and so it's kind of fun to see it trickle out throughout the days and the weeks, and it's just a really delightful, wonderful adaptation. I love the way that a lot of the different big plot points throughout the story, like Mr. Collins's proposal and the whole thing with Lydia and Wickham, are handled and adapted and updated for a modern retelling, and also just the actors and the story. It's just witty and delightful and wonderful, and I love everything about it. So if you have not checked out The Lizzie Bennet Diaries and subsequently read The Secret Diary of Lizzie Bennet, I highly recommend it. Well, there you have it, friends. Those are some of my favorite retellings. If you have any retelling recommendations for me, in particular retellings of fairy tales and also of Pride and Prejudice, because clearly I love P&P retellings, please let me know in the comments. I would love to hear what some of your favorite retellings are as well. Just another quick reminder that the 1K Q&A and giveaway is still open until this coming Tuesday, July 4th. I will link it in the card symbol above and the description below if you have not been there already and asked a question to get yourself entered into the giveaway. All the details are on that video. If you want to follow me elsewhere online, you can find me on Twitter, Instagram, and Goodreads, all at Sarianne Hayes. The links for those profiles will be in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye!